Hi, my name is Angel Jones. Today I'm here to talk to you about a strategic plan at choosing a college that best suits you. Just a little overview about choosing a college plan. Today I'm going to touch on three major concepts at choosing that college that's right for you. So you want to think about your major, what you might be interested in studying, the enrollment, that kind of goes hand in hand as far as acceptance rates and demographics go. You also want to look at the location to make sure you're in a location that is best suitable for you and your family, and also financially, because money is a big part at choosing a four-year institution or even a two-year community college. And here is just a little picture of an example acceptance letter for when you do get accepted into an institution. So first, I'm going to talk about majors and enrollment. So here's an example of a list of majors that a four-year institution may offer you. So me personally, I'm studying psychology. I don't know what you may be interested in. You may be interested in accounting, history, we even got biology, nursing, all the sorts. So when you're looking at a major, you want to also look at acceptance rates. If you know your test scores are not as high, then maybe a nursing program at a very high ranked school may not be the best choice because your acceptance level may be a little less. So things like that, and also the amount of people in the school and how many you know they accept per year per program may be another thing that you might want to look at as far as strategizing what institution may be best for you. Also, demographics. Me personally, I like a diverse learning environment. So one thing that I looked at were demographics. You want to look at gender, male and female, and also the different types of ethnicities that are represented at the university also. So my second thing that I'm going to talk about is location, as far as strategizing a good plan for school. So location, you can look at the temperature, your family's perspective, and also living expenses. So me personally, I love being close to my family, so I chose to stay in-state. That way I could get back and forth to visiting my family as much as I could. Temperature, me personally, I like hot weather. Tennessee gives me a variation, which is okay because I still get to experience the weather that I enjoy. And then also living expenses. Some people go off to college and they're off on their own. So if you move to the Northeast, well, that living expense might be a little bit higher, and also places like California. So that might be something you might want to take into consideration when you're choosing an institution that is best for you. Also, people may choose, like myself, I could have chosen to go to New York because, well, I have family in New York. Some people choose to go out of state because, well, they also have family there, so even if something happened, they'd still be close to a relative that could help them in need. My last point is financial aid. So there are different ways to get financial aid, and money is the biggest thing when it comes to choosing an institution right for you. So there are different grant programs, you can get work study, you can get scholarships, and you can also take out loans. So the biggest thing that you need to worry about is this picture right here, and it is FAFSA. Once you fill out this FAFSA form, they will grant you with loans, they will let you know if you're eligible for work study or even scholarships. Also, another thing that is available to you is our jobs on campus. So jobs on campus outside of work study give the college student a way to make money while in school. And this is really important when strategizing for an institution because some smaller schools do not offer as much money as bigger schools might. So this is a really big indicator of what dictates where you go. So just a little summary, I'll go back for a second. Just a little summary to sum everything up. So I touched on majors and enrollment. So you want to think about what you want to study and what schools may offer those programs. Also their acceptance rates for each program. You want to think about location as your second thing. So where do I see myself living after college, maybe, if you end up loving the school, where are my relatives, and what's going to be feasible for my living expenses. The third thing you want to think about is financial aid, because money definitely matters. So where am I going to get the work study or the job or the scholarships that I really need in order to not come out of pocket as much for my college tuition? And any questions?